Hello folks, me again, Rich AOL Mallorca. And today I'm heading up to Mola de Scolop. One of you asked me on my GR221 videos about a good place to stay near a peak, so that you could do a summit of a morning and then carry on along the GR221, no more than sort of like 20 minutes off the path. I racked my brains and you saw the answer hopefully. It's Mola de Scolop. It's pretty much the only one. So I thought it's a perfect excuse to get out for a wild camp. So it is Friday the 7th of April and it is about 5:30 in the afternoon. I just finished work. I had my bag packed last night and ready to go. Went home, brushed my teeth, and here we are. So this will probably be a short video. Hurrah, I hear you all shout. Because I've already done this route before, and if you want to know what the route from Escapbea to Mola de Scolop is like, you can refer back to the video below. It's purely just I've never wild camped up here before, and also to maybe help someone out with a query. Swept through the hills like wildfire, and this one area didn't get affected, but it was full of undergrowth and trees here and there and things like that. So what they've done is they're creating a natural fire break, and I guess the most ecological way of doing that is to let animals eat it. I think that's what they've done. So there you are, Mallorcan lawnmowers, loads of them. The elevation gain on this path is, like most of them in this area, immediate, I don't know if that works, sudden, steep. Awesome. Check that view out. It's only taken 15 minutes to get from the path at the bottom there up to here. It's so quiet up here. Except obviously the sound of me talking over the silence. Excellent view of the south side of Glazzo. I can make out the trig point, but you won't be able to Bit hazy today actually. Last week or so it's been crisp and clear, but obviously it's been getting warmer and warmer during the day. I think Calvia, i.e. sea level, was dropping to 8 degrees today. So probably about 5 up here, I reckon. There we go. It must be said, look, I've said a few times, GR221 official guidebook runs from Port Andratx to now Port Poyenza. We thought Poyenza. I had an old book. So, but there's loads of smaller routes where you can come on. Escap Dea to here and then on to SDX is one. There's Saracal to SDX and then carry on. There's so many of them. If you want to do the official one, it's from Port Andratx to Port Poyenza. So you won't come up here. You will come out of the trees here and cross that stile and head down to SDX. Hence why I'm showing you this pitch up here. So here you are. This is one option. It's absolutely beautiful. And as you can see, hopefully the sun, that is Skolop up there, which may look a ways away, but it's not actually a bad distance. I think it's about 30 minutes from here. There's a possibility of bivvying in here. I think I've never been in here. Yeah, I reckon you could sort something out. Get a couple of people in here. This is to do with the old observation post that's on top of Skolop. I can't remember the exact story behind it, but I'll put it at the bottom of the screen. It's deathly quiet. So yeah, I think this is going to be home for the night. As you can see, right on the trail, but I don't think I'm going to have a problem this evening, and as long as I get up super early tomorrow morning I should be alright. The views over there are pretty spectacular, up through the Tramontana. Yeah, not bad, not bad at all. I'm going to get my kit changed. Get out of these sweaty clothes. So, there she is. Great view in the background. That'll be my view in the morning. Not bad. Don't think you'd want to pitch up here if it was blowing a gale, because you can't get your pegs in very far. This whole pad is stone underneath. There's probably about that much soil on top. Seems to be holding right, but yeah, like I said, if there's a gale going, move on and forget about it. Yeah, gonna lose the sun in about 10-15 minutes, and that temperature will start dropping. Yeah, all good. I've got leftover chili for dinner tonight. I'm gonna eat that cold. Can't be asked to cook it. Bit of chocolate, some nuts and stuff. Make myself a hot chocolate. Hit the hay. Not just yet. It's only 7:15. But as soon as it starts getting dark, sun goes down at 8:20 at the moment. Yeah. So that's pretty much it. Had a bite to eat, hot chocolate, and yeah, ready for an early night, I reckon. I'm gonna set my alarm to get up early, but whether I actually do or not, I don't know. I've had some pretty early mornings for work, so wouldn't actually mind a bit of a lay-in. Plus I've got to get back down to the car in good time tomorrow morning, so yeah, one last look. Catch you in the morning. Morning, folks. So I have been lazy. The alarm went off at 7:15, but I must have slept right away through it because it's now 7:15. Yeah, actually slept pretty well last night. Quite nice. So quiet. So quiet, not a breath of wind most of the night, hence there's quite a lot of condensation on the inside of the tent. I had all the vents open, but if there's no wind, you struggle. Yeah, it was a good night. So yeah, it's 7:15 now, so I'm not going to get the sun, not going to get up to the top for sunrise. I'll just show you out the door. Looking like a beautiful morning. Not bad at all. So lovely in the sleeping bag, I don't want to get out. So yeah, I'm gonna get a pot of tea on, pack up and march back down the hill. Whew. So there we go. Sun's just poked up above Puigcalazzo. It's absolutely soaking up here this morning. Everything's damp. It's a good thing I put my hiking shoes on the floor and then put my pack on top of them. So it's kept the pack dry. And I've just had to get the pack cover out to rest it on. so it doesn't all get wet whilst I'm putting stuff away. But it's a glorious morning, absolutely stunning. Yeah. That's it. Beautiful spot. Nice vantage point up there as well. Get a good view out of over the sea. If you're walking from Port Andratch, you probably expect to get here in about 8-9 hours. I think it took us 11 hours to get to Estienx, so from Port Andratch. Still so quiet. So there we go, all packed up. Leave no trace as always. Yeah, it's a cracking spot. Just can't believe how quiet it was. Just unbelievable because there was no wind whatsoever. So yeah, just no noise after about, I don't know, 11, 12 o'clock, something like that. Yeah, so Mola Discolop. Looks like a distance, but trust me, it's about 20, 30 minutes to the top, and the views are pretty spectacular. So it's not going to take you much time at all to get up there. My original plan for this one was to camp here, do Mola Discolop, and then go round, and instead of going back down the path, where I take a right back down through the valley, you can carry straight on, go round, and end up on the top of Pudgalazzo, and then take the, I think it's probably like the eastern route down. There's like a ridge that runs from the top down to towards the east, down there into Escapdare. But that's about, from here, I think that's about 6 or 7 hours. So I haven't got time for that. It's 8:30. I'm gonna probably start jogging to the car once my legs have warmed up. Get back as quick as possible, because I've got to be over the other side of the island for my mate's triathlon. Yeah. So that was wild camp on, well, near Mola Discolop. Maybe one day I'll get the bivy out and actually stay a night up on top of it. That'd be pretty spectacular. But yeah, so I guess unless anything interesting happens, till next time, adios. Hear me. This is what it's all about.